Master coil or master motor test feature is commonly used by coil, motor, and generator manufacturers. Primarily used when you're testing the same motor type or coil type repeatedly. And there are a few different ways to do the setup. We are going to show the more common way this feature is used. If you have any special applications or questions about it, don't hesitate to contact us and we will do our best to help explain how this software or how this feature can be modified to work best with your application. In this example, we are using an iTIG 4 kV version, model D. This is also available in the higher voltage tester, so 6, 12, and 15 kV, and can be used with power packs as well if you need to do testing up to 40,000 volts. The test subject for this demonstration will be a single phase motor with the start and run coil. It's kind of an interesting little guy. It'll have some very big differences in the three waveforms just because of how it's wound and connected. That'll allow us to show how this master motor, master coil feature works. So to get started, we go over to the tester, we click start. We're at the customer directory. We already entered in the motor type in this case, or motor ID in the database. So it's the top line here. So we select the motor type we want to test. We have the information we need already entered in. So the first thing to do is we need to define a master for this motor type. We haven't done any tests on this one yet, so that'll be the first task. So we say test. You probably already see in the demonstration videos for the various models, we always work away from left to right. We're on the last tab here, the test summary screen. Here we can enter in a few more pieces of information in the test description field. In this case, I am going to enter in master, just to define that in our database, that this will be the test set we use as our master or reference. And we can also enter in a test stage and operator if that's helpful for your reporting purposes. Next step, we go to the setup screen. At the top here, we see our high pot and surge test voltage formulas. Any of the white fields can be changed, or the test voltage itself can be overridden in the column on the far right. I'm going to leave it as is for now. Next step here is auto mode and limits setup. So this is where we define which measurements and tests we should include in this case, the full auto sequence, as well as the pass-fail criteria for this motor type or motor ID. So for the purpose of showing the master motor feature, we're going to focus on the surge test. All the other measurements, including inductance, capacitance, impedance, winding resistance, mega ohm high pot, and partial discharge for that matter, can be defined in the setup, but the surge test is the main feature that we want to look at. So in this case, I'm going to unselect the other measurements and tests, leave surge highlighted green. The top here, again, we're going to select it as a three-phase application. It's not really a three-phase, but it's a fun example of what it could look like. If it's a single-phase application, then you click the single-phase icon. Same motor test configuration. This will now be defined as the test set, so that includes test voltages and pass-fail criteria for this motor type. Exit setup, and we now want to run that surge test to collect our waveforms for lead 1, 2, and 3, which will be used as the references for every subsequent motor tested against this master. So, start full auto test. We've already connected lead 1, 2, and 3 to our test subject here. Ground clip is on. Press the red button. It will go through and do the surge test in all the three phases. As you can tell, the waveforms do not overlap at all, which is what we expect for this application. So now we'll see what this looks like when we save it as a master. click the folder button, exit test mode, everything is automatically saved. So from this step, we now go to view print past tests. We see the time and date stamp or test record of the test we just ran through. Notice the test description field has the master identifier in it. So the top left corner here, we now select to use this as our master. It will enter in the time and date stamp of this master test that we just did. Hit the folder button to exit out. And we are now ready to continue testing all the other motors similar or identical to this. So let's assume that the next motor comes off the line. You make your connections to serial number one, for example, and you want to test that against the original master. Back over to the tester, we now say test versus master coil. We're back to our test summary screen, and the test description field in this case, I would enter in the serial number of this specific motor. So last time we entered in the master description, that could have been a serial number for that matter, but for all the subsequent tests, this is how you identify which motor you're actually testing on. So let's say serial number one, and then back to our setup screen. Everything that we defined, including test voltages, measurements and tests, pass-fail criteria, already saved, so there's no setup required. So you just click start full auto test and it will memorize all the other stuff that we did, including the lead one waveform, lead two waveform and lead three waveform. So we'll now compare lead one on this motor to lead one on the master. We'll also compare lead two on this one to lead two on the master and lead three to lead three on the master. And then we'll apply our pass fail criteria to those tests. Press the red button. It will go through. It has everything memorized from our master or reference. And as you can tell, it will then calculate the percent wave difference, lead one to lead one, lead two to lead two, lead three to lead three. And those are nice and low, which is what we expect. And we therefore have a passed test. So we're all good. We can folder out, exit test mode, and test versus master coil again, and start the next test set on serial number two. At the end of the day, you can folder out, view print past test, you can print reports the normal way, and you can also use the test summary CSV file to generate a very quick and easy overview of the test results for all serial numbers tested.